Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this bag. And you make them using just a regular standard medium size envelope. We're going to make this one. If you voted on my blog, this is the one that got voted to be the one that I demonstrate how to make in the video. They're actually made the exact same way. The measurements are the same. The only difference is I use a different embossing folder. This is the Perfect Polka Dots and this is the Vintage Wallpaper. And then I just cut the worm out with my scissors. So they're made the same. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is seal the envelope. Okay, so I've sealed the envelope. And then I'm going to just cut off just a tiny strip on each side, okay? And then next what we're going to do is take the scallop border punch. And we're going to give it some scallop edges. Now when you're doing the envelopes, you can do both both layers. You can't do two pieces of cardstock with this punch. Just you can do really thin paper, okay? Next what we're going to do is score it. So we're going to score the bottom at 1.5. And then you're going to score each side at 1/2 inch. Okay, so let's go ahead and fold these on the score lines. Okay. Now what we're going to do is set this on the, put it on the Big Shot and we're going to emboss it. Okay, so I'm going to grab that. Okay, so I'm going to use the multi-purpose platform and normally you use tab 1 for your embossing folders, but I'm going to use this one. Okay. I'm going to put down one cutting pad. I'm going to layer my envelope inside of the embossing folder. Put it on the Big Shot and then run it through, okay? Okay, let me get this out of the way. Okay, so now we'll take this out of here. Now it's going to be a little bit harder to see your score lines, but they are there, okay? So at this point, because the embossing is pretty deep, you want to be careful of when you're folding it on the score lines. I will admit the dots are a little bit easier because it's not as busy. With the vintage wallpaper one, it's a busier pattern. So you have to be careful that you don't rip it. And that's why I didn't use tab 2, okay? I'm going ahead and folding it like this. That just kind of preps it. There we go. And there we go. See? So there we have it. Okay, so let's decorate it. What we're going to do is take the Baja Breeze seam binding. I'm going to wrap this around the bottom. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is add the handle. So what I'm going to do is take my hole punch, and I'm just going to punch a hole on the back side, okay? Okay, so to attach this, you're just going to thread it through the hole there and then tie a knot. And then decide how long you want your handle. Now be careful when you're working with this seam binding. See how I've kind of roughed it up a little bit? I'm not very graceful today. Okay, so let's trim these up. I could have done a better job. I think it's twisted. There we go. Okay, so now let's stamp our image. Okay, so we're going to use Baja Breeze ink. We're going to punch this out with the 1¾ circle punch. I'm going to sponge the edge just to kind of soften it up a little. We're going to use the 2⅜ scallop circle punch. And I'm going to use a dimensional just to kind of pop it up. Now, for everyone that stayed until the very end of my video, if you go and leave a comment on my blog that you watched the video, I'm going to draw a winner on Friday, because I'm not announcing this on my blog. I am only announcing this on the video. So if you watch the video to the very end, go leave a comment on my blog and let me know that you watched the video, and I'll draw a winner. I'll send this to you in the mail. Okay? Thanks a lot. If you have any questions, let me know. Bye.